everyone, we are now in Gaborone. Yay, the big smoke, right? And these are my beautiful hosts, Brenda and Neil. And now it's weekend, so guys are taking me for a little tour around town and yeah, to see what's the, yeah. What are we gonna see today in Gabs?
I think we're gonna start off with a little tour through the main mall. We'll go up through
yes,
the main mall.
Yes, that sounds exciting.
And then we'll come out the other side and head off to the Yacht Club.
And are we going to see the dam as well?
We'll see the dam.
We're going to see so many things today.
And yeah, maybe even some yachts will be out, who knows?
Yeah.
And then we're going to go on to Mokolodi Game Reserve.
Okay, cool. So we've got lots of things planned for today. Let's go.
Let's go.
And this is where you can buy cosmetics, clothing, everything, food, souvenirs, traditional food.
Right, the place to be. It's quite small, isn't it? I thought it was going to be, but probably it's just Corona times, right?
It's, no, this is about it.
This is it? Oh, this is cute.
Good thing.
So cool. Hello, look at beautiful things here. This is ostrich egg here. Where you put it?
You put it here. Uh-huh.
What's this made out of?
Hey, this thing is from the tree.
Ah.
Yeah, it is from the tree. Yeah.
That's clever. Thank you.
Thank you.
Traditional Botswana colors.
Yes, it is beautiful. Very pretty.
So awesome fashion.
I know. I think that's very pretty. Botswanian colors. Okay, so this one or a different one. It goes like all here. So which one do you reckon?
I prefer the second one.
This one?
Or both?
Both, yes. And we also have something like that. That's nice too, isn't it?
That's the best one.
Is it?
And that's the Botswana flag.
Yes. And oh, there's also one like that.
Actually, that one. Take them all, I think.
No, I can't fit them on a bus. And we have, wait, something smaller. So which one? On the hair?
Yeah, a little bit.
Like this?
Yeah.
And girls dance with it, right?
Yeah.
Oh. How's my hair?
Keep the flies away.
So I will take this one.
Okay.
I think this is my favorite.
I think so too. Okay.
Oh, look at that. Like,
Like that.
Wow, look at that. I'm looking for something that, you know, I can always have it on.
Look, this one.
Too big. Too big.
Too big.
This is Botswana, right?
Yeah.
Look.
Pretty.
How's that?
Very pretty.
Oh, this one. Which one?
The color.
Colors.
Colored?
Colored.
And how much is this one, sir?
No, the same as
150? 50. Okay. Thank you so much. It was nice to meet you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We're ready. Next stop, Gaborone Yacht Club. Welcome to Gaborone Yacht Club. Yes, we are in the middle of the land, and I was actually quite surprised that there is a yacht club here in town. And it's actually quite a stunning area, because this is all because of the dam, right?
This is because of the dam. As Neil was saying earlier, we have an annual raft race here where people build rafts or come with their sailboats, and it is a popular windy day activity in Gabs.
And is it like, it's just like a lot of people have just boats, kayaks here and just enjoy the, like, I don't know, a day on the water, on weekends on the water.
Day
right?
on the water, a day in the sun, and we're now going to the Yacht Club bar where you can enjoy a nice meal.
Who are they?
This is some rock lizards.
What do you call them?
They're called dassies. Some rock rats.
I can see you. Yes. Look at staring competition here. They're not shy, hey?
Not at all.
Saturday.
Cheers, Kinga.
Cheers, Kinga.
Let's hope you're not on your bike soon and stay another day.
No, thank you so much. Yes, please. This is lovely. Thank you so much, Brenda, for this lovely present.
Thank you.
How do I look?
You look like Cleopatra.
Botswana. And now it's lunch time. We are in Mokolodi Bush Kitchen. Is that your favorite place here?
It's a beautiful restaurant set in the middle of a natural game reserve.
Oh, nice.
So hopefully we're going to have some zebra, buck, elephant, giraffe.
Oh really? There's viewing in the restaurant. Oh,
come
so nice.
To view us while we eat.
That's so nice. Okay, let's check it out.
Hello.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Let's see what's on the menu.
So, Brenda, where are we today?
This afternoon we are having lunch at the Mokolodi Bush Kitchen and we have honoured guests with us. If you look to your left, Kinga, you will see these beautiful zebra that are about to come into the restaurant to join us for lunch.
Oh, thank you very much for this little interview. Enjoy your mojito.
Cheers.
How's my hair? Right, and our meal has arrived. So, Neil and I, we're having shanks, lamb shanks. Yes, very fancy. And Brenda got calamari because we're right at the coast.
Super fresh. Cheers, guys. Enjoy your meal. Thank you for taking me here.
Bon appetit.
Thank you.
Okay, let's try. Heaven, right?
That is heaven. Delicious.
Perfect. This is our last attraction for today. Guys, where are we? Oh, sorry, Sean, I have to introduce you first. So this is Sean and we are at Madison Square. What do you guys do here?
Good afternoon. Yeah, we catch snakes and relocate them. And here we actually keep about 65 different snakes, venomous and non-venomous, which we show the public and we educate the schools. And yeah, we just generally look after the reptiles.
So tell me, Sean, how did you come up with this? Because this is not a business, you're actually doing it for free. This is your sort of like hobby right now.
Yeah, so this was done because we saw a need for people to be educated on reptiles, because you know, there's a massive fear of snakes.
Sure.
So we started catching snakes and relocating from town, and we've been catching 15 to 20 in the busy months.
Wow.
Then we decided to start educating the public, so we started keeping them, and then we've got, like I said, 55, 56, 60 snakes here. And then we've been to companies. Brenda and Neil, for example, have sponsored a cage before, which helps us run costs.
Oh,
and then we started adding extra things. We've got tortoises, we've got water monitors, got a couple of pigs running around, we've got rabbits, we've got ducks, we've even got a fishing pond for kids to catch fish.
So who funds this? Because you're not getting paid for it. Do you have government?
I fund it myself.
Oh,
so
wow.
Through the training, we do get
you
money,
a bit
and
of
then,
money.
Like I said, Brenda and a couple of other guys, Brenda and Neil, have sponsored cages,
mm-hmm.
and that helps to pay the wages and some of the costs.
So when you capture a snake, what do you do with it?
So can we go inside and have a look?
Sure, definitely. Let's do that.
This is our training room. We do a theory in the morning, and then they write a test, and in the afternoon they'll go out and catch a puff adder, snouted cobra, spitting cobra, and a big python.
Oh, wow.
And through here, all the cages. So here we've got famous black mamba.
Okay. This is black mamba.
So it's
wow.
all the fears about the snake are unfounded. It's not aggressive. It doesn't chase people. Yes, it's got a serious neurotoxic venom. I've had a call today where a guy was bitten by a snake, which we're trying to help at the moment.
Uh-huh.
We've had two black mamba bites in the last 3 years.
So if black mamba bites you, how much time you've got to get the?
Look, the worst case, right? I'm talking about the real worst. Okay, it's not right, 30 minutes to half, and 30 minutes to an hour and you're in trouble. But there are first aid procedures that you can do to limit the,
right.
you know, the time frame.
Right.
So this guy here is a boomslang. Okay, in Botswana the females will be brown and the males will normally be green. So they're dimorphic, so they can tell by the colour.
She's very pretty.
That's
she?
That's a snouted cobra. So that guy gets up to about 2.5 metres. It's a neurotoxic venom, same venom as a black mamba, but not as potent.
Someone lost their skin.
Okay, so this is just a harmless egg eater. So what it does, it eats these eggs. Egg
really?
Eater. It's a specialist feeder. It feeds.
Where is he now?
I'm trying to find him.
He's hiding?
Yeah. So it's completely harmless. I mean, this doesn't even have teeth.
Oh, wow. He's very cute.
They are there and there.
So how often does he lose his skin?
So they snakes
really?
Shed if they... If
Woo!
They, so there's the latest shed.
Oh wow.
Yeah, so snakes, I mean adult snakes sort of 6-8
Can
times
I touch
a year.
Him?
Yeah, sure.
Ew.
Very cool.
Very cool.
This is a burrower.
So this is
so even though it looks scary, I mean it's
so he's harmless. Good?
It will hurt you but it won't kill you.
Right. Good to know. Oh no, you're not
so,
afraid.
So
ooh, so these are bad, yeah?
So that's the parrot.
Okay,
yeah.
So this one we don't want to be near them, near him. Okay. Roger that. Oh wow. It's
just with a torch, you can see them, right? Oh, no, this is fluorolite, yeah?
Yes.
It's a fluorolite. Oh, wow. And they normally, they're black. You can't see them, right? I mean,
yeah,
just
in the,
black.
If I turn it off, it's just
it's nothing.
Nothing.
Wow. That's so cool. And who's he? Python.
So the African python. So those guys get up to about 4.5, 5.5 meters.
And he can...
So he's a constrictor.
Yeah, so he can, like...
So in Southern Africa, there hasn't been...
around your neck and just like...
Well, there's been, in the last 100 years, there hasn't been a Southern African python fatality.
Okay, so, you know, so another bad.
They get a bad rap, they don't really...
Okay. I like your house, mate. He's very comfortable. He pretends to be a turtle. So cool. Thank you. Oh, where is he going? Where is he going for a walk? Oh wow, he is very cool. Ooh, is he, are you gonna just let him go? No. So sometimes you're gonna just take them for a walk like this? Just for the presentation.
So often when you find these guys, especially the males, they have a lot of, see there's a scar there?
Yeah.
So the males bite each other when they're looking for suitable females.
Oh my god, how many snakes you have in your hand now?
Three.
Can I touch them?
Sure.
You're very nice. Oh wow, look at you.
Very cool.
Oh wow, I think they like each other, hey?
Yeah,
they like a family?
Yeah, they're very cool with each other now.
Huh. How close can you get to the snake?
As close as you want.
He's not interested.
So if you put your finger at the end there, okay,
I see what
okay,
you mean.
Tell me when it's sore, and I'm pressing as
close
as I can. Is it
sore
yet?
Okay. Yeah, it's not true.
Put your finger closer, it gets sore almost straight away.
Right, of
so
course.
If they catch the snake in the wrong back, they're going to break its back.
So you need to catch the snake here at the end,
right? Right at the end, yeah.
Okay.
She's very cute.
Oh, he's so cute.
It's awesome, man.
So cute. Hold on, I'll have to take a picture as well.
So, I think he likes the salt.
So you rescue a lot of animals, hey?
Yeah, the guys bring us all sorts of bits and pieces.
And so these bunnies are not going to be eaten, right?
Chicken.
You promise?
Yeah.
Give me the name of that bison.
This is the live piggy, isn't it?
They've had a good life, these guys.
Yeah. This is your latest rescue,
yeah?
He looks a bit poor.
So you can see where the hair is good. That's what it was all... bird like that, and we're slowly but surely taking it out.
He looks like he's been through a lot. His name is Ben. Ben says hi. It's time to leave Gaborone. So recently Chile had a little bit of servicing done. For the very first time I've changed my front brake plate. She's done over 100,000 on the original one. So I think it was time to change it finally. They were like very, very wobbly. And she's got new tires on, Bridgestone, Adventure Cross, the only tires I use. So it's very exciting. She's good to go. What my plan is from now on, well, I'm leaving Botswana and I'll be pretty much transiting back to Mozambique just to chill. So unfortunately, Zimbabwe is still closed. Come, come here, come on. Don't be shy. Hi, say hi, hi. That's my favorite doggy, and this is my second favorite doggy. Come here, come. You want to be on YouTube? Come here. Come, you can be on YouTube too. Ah. Go. So my plan is to leave Botswana today. Unfortunately, Zimbabwe is closed. So again, every time I'm ready to enter Zimbabwe, it's closed. So I've been very unlucky. I'm devastated that I probably won't get the chance to go to Zimbabwe. Because slowly I'm getting ready for the shipment to North America. But before that happens, I've got a couple of months to kill, so I'm transiting now to Mozambique just to meet up with some friends and chill at the beach. Maybe possibly do a kitesurfing training. Yes.
And I'm leaving Gaborone in the rain. Oh, nothing like riding in the rain on new tires. I'm just taking it easy for now. It's just getting worse and worse. And now we've got the lightning. It's gonna be a long way to the border. Officially now my pants are already wet and my boots. Because of course I want my boots over my pants. Oh dear.